YouTube Shorts are booming, and one way to take over this trend is to create shorts in bulk with minimal effort, aka repurposing your YouTube videos. So in this video, I'll show you how to turn a YouTube video into a short using the YouTube app, and later, how you can create better edits from your long form videos using pre-made templates and your own creativity. Let's go. So open up the YouTube app on your iPhone or Android device. Note that you can only do this with your own channel's videos, not someone else's. Click on the videos tab on your channel and then select the video that you want to turn into a YouTube short and then click remix. Here, a window pop-up will appear listing several options, including using just the audio from the video, using the video as a background for a new video, and the one that we'll be focusing on, editing the video into a short. Once you click on this option, you'll be taken to the video editor, and the first thing you will notice are the black bars around your video. This is a guideline to show you what will appear in your YouTube short. You can see that you can't fit the entire video into a portrait screen, and although you can swipe along to adjust the placement, you are stuck with that placement for the entire short. Meaning, if you have more than one subject in a video, you won't be able to have both on screen at the same time. This can quickly become irritating, but later in the video, I'll show you another way to turn your YouTube video into a short which overcomes this problem. But for now, you can switch between creating a 15-second short and a 60-second one by clicking on the number 15 in the top right corner. Use the timeline at the bottom to scroll through your video to find the section that you want to turn into a short. Also notice how you can't make a cut in the video, so your entire short has to come from one continuous clip from your original YouTube video, which again can quickly become tedious. You can use the white bars and drag them along the timeline to change the start and end points of the video. Once you are happy with your new YouTube short, click next and wait for it to load. Once it is loaded, you can add text, change the font, add a background to the text, change the color of it, add a voiceover, and even a filter. You can also change the amount of time that the text is on screen for by clicking on the timeline tab and dragging the end button to the desired position. Watch through your video to make sure you are happy with your new YouTube short, and when you are ready to schedule or share it, click next. Add a title to your short, and YouTube even offers hashtags that could be useful in promoting your content. Choose the visibility of the video and either press upload short or save as draft. So although it is an easy process, you can see how it could quickly become frustrating if your video doesn't quite fit within the constraints of a portrait layout. So that's why I'm now going to show you how to overcome these issues and turn a YouTube video into a short using VEED. Head to VEED and you can either select one of the many customizable templates, or you can start fresh and upload your own YouTube video. If you've started from scratch, click on the settings button on the sidebar, and this is where we can resize your video to turn it from a YouTube video to a YouTube short. Select the size drop-down menu and click on YouTube Short, and VEED will now automatically resize your video. Click and drag the video on the video canvas to center your subject and use the corner buttons to drag and change the size. You can even resize the entire video to show the whole original landscape video in case you don't want to crop anything out. You could then add text above or below in the empty spaces.
Over the next 24 hours, we experience a tour of a medieval castle.
Now that we've resized the YouTube video, again, unlike in the YouTube app, we can go through and edit out specific sections. Use the playhead in the timeline to find the beginning and end points of the section that you want to edit. Press S on your keyboard, or you can press Spilt just above the timeline. Do the same for the end as well. You can now delete the rest of the clips in the timeline by holding down Shift, selecting the clips, and pressing the backspace button on your keyboard. You can now click on the empty space in the timeline, delete it, and your clip will jump to the beginning. Once you've made all your edits, watch through the short, and if you need to readjust the video on the video canvas to keep your subject central, do so. Now, if you're a regular uploader to YouTube, you know just how strict they are on what music you use. So if you want to avoid any possible copyright strikes and demonetization, VEED offers a built-in stock audio library that you can use for all your shorts too. Simply search a keyword or use the playlist to find a piece of copyright-free music and add it to your short. You can then adjust the length of the audio clip accordingly. When you are happy with your newly edited YouTube short, click the Done button in the top right corner and press Export Video. Wait for VEED to render out your video, and when it's finished, hit download and then download as MP4. And here's the result of turning my YouTube video into a short using VEED.
And now we're coming up to the main reason that me and my boyfriend wanted to come to Carcassonne.
And this
is the view. From here, I can upload it to YouTube from my desktop, add a title, description, and choose when to release it. And that's how easy it is to turn your YouTube video into a short. Now that you know how to do this, why not learn how to increase retention and engagement by adding subtitles to your shorts by watching this video here? I hope you found this helpful, and I'll see you next time.